Hey everybody, I am wearing a dinosaur head on my head, rawr. And I am expecting an order of wood today. I've heard that the carrier pigeons have started a delivery service where they bring in wood. It's not the fastest service, but they have a whole bunch of it. If you do go ahead, actually you have to harvest it yourself. I'm uncovered still. So today, man, we need to do some stuff together. We need to build some more platforms. I have 7, and we're going to talk as that's going on there. There's a wood. Okay, wood, and we're going to do that. 7. Oh, I only have enough for 1. What do I need? Wood. And now I have 6, 7, 8. That would put me at 14, which would be 3. We need to do 3 by 4. 3 by 4 is 12. 4 by 4. 4 by 5 is 20. 8 is 14. How do you like that math in my head? All right, let's craft this and do some talking. So 15 would be 3 by 5. That'd actually be really nice. Today, what we're going to do is, you probably noticed by the video description. Ooh, energy brew. Very neat. So these are recipes I've been finding while killing things. Actually, got a lot of stuff here, which is awesome. So today we're going to be building a cooking station, right? I want to ride you. Hopefully, yeah, we're too slow still. I was going to show you guys a top-down look at our island here. Basically, that gate right there, that opening right there, takes you down to Paradise City, where the grass is green and the girls are pretty. No, that's like the biggest opening, so the biggest dinos can go up there. What is that dino? Oh, it's a Samsquatch. Huh, cool. And then over here, there's another opening, which is kind of a smaller one. Let's see. This one's not as big over here, so it'll be a little bit harder to navigate dinos up. And then, actually, this one's okay. And then on this corner, is actually a really tiny one, and I hate using it. So what we're going to do eventually, we need to get our mammoth, right? We need to get the mammoth, and I want to build a fence entirely around this place. Like, build a fence all the way around, and then have, like, a behemoth gate right here so we can get big dinos up here. And then on these other two sides, we'll have just regular old fence rooskies and just dinosaur gates, not the behemoth gates. So we need to find a place to do a kind of a cooking shack. We're going to redo this guy eventually. And I needed a place, because we're going to do a fence around here. So I've been thinking, like, right in here. So we're going to do a fence. I should really lay out the foundations of the fence. Right in here, we're going to do the gate. So if I come, like, right over here, then and make up a little platform, it should be nice. Oh, you can sit down now. Thank you, pink guy. You helped out nicely. Actually, please go. Let's move you. Hey, wait, we'll do this. We're going to move you out of the way just a tad bit, like so. So I'm thinking, like, give enough area to get up in here, and then turn a big dino, and then, like, start it right in here. I think this would be a good area. So let's get to it. We're going to put down 16, which would not be quite 3x5, but I will do 3x5 anyway, because my counting is broken. Okay. And I can't tell how far away from the edge I am. So, can I zoom out more? I don't know. I think that's going to be pretty good. I hope this is squared. Let's check. I should have turned it more that way, shouldn't I have? Like, yeah, let's do that. Demolish. I hate demolishing things because you get half your resources back. It takes me forever in a weekend to get this resource. Like, wood is one thing that we need to get our mammoth for. Quick, fast, and in a hurry. So we're going to do 5 wide and only 3 deep. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, let's just do 4 wide for right now. And we'll see how it goes. Because we're going to put in some things here. We're going to make it an open area. I don't want it to be enclosed. Just like that. All right. So I did get pillars. I made pillars too. Hey, bird brain, come here. And we're going to put in, actually, let's just put all of this stuff back in you, like that. And then I have some pillars, and I don't think that works. We're going to try it anyway. I probably need to get some of these back. I need to make like a back wall, I think. We're gonna try the pillars in the corner, and I think I can put a ceiling on pillars. I don't quite know for sure, but I don't think I could put the sloped wooden structure. So if I put you, you don't even line up properly. What kind of good are you for? Ungood in the neighborhood. That's awesome. I'm going to put two down, and I'm going to see if I can do anything with it. And I don't think, just for funsies, it's... Yeah, nothing connects. Alright. Hey, who are you? Okay, go in. There we go. First person mode. Okay, right click. Let's hit like that, and then we'll demolish these. Again, I hate doing that, but it's okay. We can do it. Alright. Why did I remove thatch and stuff? Okay, so let's make some walls up. I'm going to need to grab some more stuff. We'll just do a back wall, I guess. We'll see if that'll be enough. Then we can put fake pillars in. Should pretend like it holds it up. And that should be wood. We only need four. Encumbered. Craft. We could do like the windows, couldn't we? That'd be funner. I think that'll be good. Craft all five. I'll do four instead. How's that sound? One, two, three, four. Yeah, I did my counting good. Okay, and then we're going to put the stuff back in as soon as it's gone. Sorry I didn't do all this off camera. I wanted to bring you guys with me on it, though. So, that's my method to my madness. Okay, we'll plop that in there since there's no water in it anyway. And it doesn't really matter because you can't really drink it anymore. Ooh, that was close. Okay, and nine. If you are wondering why I have dodo eggs in my inventory, it's because I've been eating dodo eggs. They take up a ton of space. Really? For real? You're gonna do this to me right now. This is sloped. It's sloped ceiling, isn't it? That's really cute. That's really, really cute. Can I get a different angle at it, maybe? Come on. Maybe. There we go. I don't know if I can build from the ceiling. Okay, let's just plop. Now if I hit E, E dismounts you. Are you kidding me? How in the world am I supposed to do this? Wow. Okay, I'm going to have to figure this out. I'll be right back. All right, so I'm taking a bit of a break from building the old the cooking shop here. And BTC had offered to come lend a hand. And he brought over a mammoth that he wants to level up. I accidentally ran into an Alpha Raptor somewhere down along here. He's really close and kind of too close for comfort. Oh, you can kind of see, like, right above Mammoth's head, there's like a reddish area. Ooh, maybe I'll see with my scope. Let's see. But he's right down there somewhere.
He's stuck in a tree. The moment I start attacking him, the tree. Oh, there it is, right there. Yeah, the moment I start attacking him, the tree's probably gonna break.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna see if I can not break the tree so that way he doesn't get loose. Worst case scenario, if he starts going after Poopy, just run.
Okay. Can do. I'll try to stay in distance here.
Yeah. So the reason I brought the mammoth over is because in order to get XP on your dinos, you either have to the dino itself either has to be attacking or someone has to be riding it. So I brought Poopy over here in order to level him up because this is like a 108, 116?
104, I think it was.
104?
Yep.
So, and this RG that I have is specifically made to kill alpha T-Rexes, so this should make short work of this.
Cool.
All right, we're just going to air break.
Okay,
hold on. Let me try to get a better angle here.
It's in a tough spot, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay. Oh, and it goes to the tree. All right, yeah.
Okay.
That's okay. All right, he's loose.
Yep,
he's loose.
I see that. Backing up.
Yeah, as long as he stays on me, it'll be fine. Like, he can attack me all day. He's not really going to do much damage.
Okay.
I found a really, really awesome journeyman saddle recipe.
Nice.
For Argies, and it's, like, crazy amounts of armor. So, like, this guy, he's already pretty bloody. He's doing a little bit of damage to me, but I'm kind of being careless.
I'm going to try to get it in the scope here so I can watch.
You can start moving a little closer, I think.
Okay. Just make sure... I don't want to aggro him, but I want you to get that XP.
There it goes.
You got it.
Super, super easy.
Cool.
And what do we get on him?
You got 7,615 experience now.
Not bad. Let's see. We got journeyman bone, journeyman bow, journeyman crossbow, metal pick, some other garbage. So, if you need any of this stuff, go ahead and grab it, because I have stuff that's better than this. So.
A gun? I don't have a gun yet.
Knock yourself out. I got a Mastercraft pistol here. This thing is great.
Wow.
I love it. Most people don't use the guns, but mm-hmm. I don't know. I really like them.
Are these bows any good? Ramshackle. Ooh, journeyman crossbow.
Yeah. The cross, that should be really good. That's 178. It's a very good crossbow.
Nice.
I mean, it's not like amazing, but it's definitely a very, very solid one.
Very cool.
Do you need, do you have like an industrial grill or anything?
I don't have any of that yet.
Okay. All right. Well, if you want prime meat, you can harvest off of the alpha, and basically it's going to give you nothing but prime meat.
Yeah, it gives.
So
I killed one last episode and it gave me like 25.
Okay.
I'll be fine on that.
All right.
Do you mind if I kill some trees here for a second?
Yeah, go for it. Knock yourself out.
Oh, my word.
Poopy some experience there.
That's amazing. That's so much better than X.
Yeah. Poopy is bred from two perfect mammoths that I happened to I found them at the same time. Like,
what?
I was, I was flying out around and I saw a 120 mammoth. I'm like, oh my god, a 120 mammoth! And I got a tame it, and I grabbed it with my Quetzal, and I brought it back to my base. And when I got back to my base, there was a 120 mammoth female that was right there. And I'm like, oh my god. So I got to tame a 120 male and female mammoth, like, at the same time. It was pretty cool.
And I assume you had all of the kibble
that
you needed.
The kibble and stuff? Oh, yeah.
That's cool. I've barely got enough kibble right now. Like, I threw away a stack of wood. I've got enough kibble right now where I can tame one 120 mammoth. So, or I've got enough eggs that I could do it. So I'm looking forward to that day.
Yeah, there's a ton of mammoths where I am. So, cool. I mean, it's the only place they spawn, but there's a lot of high-level ones, too.
That's good. This guy, he definitely needs his levels. I'll totally let you do that. He slows down with all of these.
I haven't pumped his weight or anything. I'm gonna do that shortly. I wanted to kind of figure out exactly where I want to go with like the speed and stuff. I really like this area here, man. This is awesome. The little like swirling plateau thing.
Mm-hmm.
This is one of the cooler places in the game. How close are you to the swamp?
It's real close. Just fly right north and Zildjian, you could actually see it if you fly up a little bit.
You
can see the swamp.
You know, like, the trees in the swamp don't have, like, the berries and stuff near them? So if you use a mammoth, like, you just get all wood. Just wood. It's great. I mean,
but it's a lot more dangerous for me.
Yeah, once you get a Quetzal, you might be able to, like, just, you know, fly him over there, drop your mammoth, collect, you know, a couple thousand wood, and then just come back.
Oh, yeah, that wouldn't be bad at all. A couple thousand wood.
I mean, it sounds silly because you have so many trees near you, but you'll notice collecting with the mammoth, like, you're going to get so many berries.
There are a ton.
Yeah.
Like, every hit I get, like, that one hit I got 127 tintos.
Yeah, so you have to, like, open the inventory, mm-hmm. drop all the berries.
Dump them, keep going.
It just becomes kind of a pain.
Huh. Tell you what, I'm definitely longing for a mammoth now. Longing to tame one.
Well, if you find one, and you want to tame it, like, in the area, then you can just drop it off at my base. There's actually a place on my roof where you can Like, I made, like, a little wooden area where you can just drop the mammoth in it, knock it out, and tame it without having to worry about it getting eaten by something.
Nice. I'll have to do that. Maybe I'll need a heavy lifter, too. But tell you what, I'll let you have your furball back, and I will get to be finishing up my little cooking house there.
All right, man. Have a good one.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Oh, wait. All right. Here it is, the great unveil. I built it. Well, I did. You probably saw that from the thumbnail, too. Ha! Well, I didn't do the whole pillar idea. Because, well, it didn't. It pretty much didn't work the way I wanted it to. So I figured I wanted good airflow by using these things. Man, I tell you what, it is a pain in the royal sphincter to try to get these things to line up right. This game has some broken building mechanics to me. I mean, I'm still a rookie and everything, but I just, wow, it's annoying. I've done a couple things, so it's nice and roomy. What I actually did is I added on another one over here. I added this guy on, which is weird, and I'm getting a lot of, like, artifacting going on. If it blinks and stuff while I'm doing this, I apologize. But yeah, it's nice and roomy in here. It's, I guess it's the same style as that one. Is it the same size? No, that's 3. This is 3. I done make it the same. Oh, I made it one bigger. Yes. So the cooking shack is one bigger. I might make another floor up there too. And it feels like this one feels a lot more open than this one does over here. Oh, and check it out. Plants are growing. Plants are growing. But I did want to take you guys with me as I put some more stuff down. Oh yeah, I need to get some more things. Get pooped. Oh, gross. Nasty bird. But yeah, BTC was kind enough to come over here. I think I could have done it with Pink Eye, but since I put it in the chat and he needed to level up his mammoth, and it got him, like, I don't know how many levels. You guys probably saw how much XP he got because I did the thing beforehand, or showed the XP before and after. So he could have said how much XP he got, but he did really good, and I'm glad he could help up. It's always nice to get to know some of the other guys on the server. But yeah, it was fun, and I got a new shirt out of the deal, and a new crossbow, which I'm really pumped about, and some other really cool things. Oh, and I got that pistola, so it's awesome. I'm excited for that. But yeah, I'm gonna put this down. I needed to get that stuff. I didn't get any flint out of that, did I? Oh, great. I don't think I did. Maybe I did. I don't think I did, though. Flint. I got flint. Okay, so cooking pot. Cooking. Oh, I can do it. I can do a crafty item. Craft a cooking pot. Yes, go. Dun 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 dun. Cooking pot. Maybe. Hiya. I actually have no idea how to use this. I saw other people with it, so I thought it'd be cool if I made one. And I know you have to have it for whatever those things are called. The kibbles. Kibbles and bits. 9. Oh boy. Oh, okay. I was hoping it didn't have to be placed on the ground. That would have been annoying. Can you turn at all? Man, you're actually, that's kind of a bad spot. Well, too late now. Great. Well, so I did make up a bunch of these things too, if I can come over here to Pink Eye. I made up a bunch of get rid of you, and I put on one of those shirts on myself. Get rid of you, that'll be fine. And I made some of these. I made 6 preserving bins. I'm hoping I can put these monsters along this wall. I'm not sure if that's possible though. So let's try this out. Preserving bin. That's not a preserving bin. 8. Okay, if I turn you like so, can't tell. This game, man. This game has some wonky mechanics to it. So, kind of get in there? Okay. See, then you can turn it too, which is really weird. You get as close as possible, walk straight backwards. So why could I turn this thing, but I couldn't turn the cooking pot? I don't know. I don't get it. 4? Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. That's really comfortable and cute. Good job, game. Okay, 8. I got, like, 2 more of these things left. Great. I'm hoping these get lined up right. See, now I can't see it again. That looks okay.
And then we'll do one more. You know, I could probably fit another one in there. But yeah, I thought this would be cool to have these, and then I could use, like, this one could be only for cooked meat, and then this one can be for berries, and then this one, and this one, and this one. I gotta get a fridge eventually. I thought it'd be cool to have those going. And then the cooking pot. I don't actually know how... Oh, ow. Tribute, 1,000 wishbones. I wasn't expecting to actually see anything in here. But yeah, you put in different things. I don't know if you put the recipe in. I'm gonna have to try to find that out. Try to find it out for sure. And I don't want to summon him, but that's a really, really weird deal. It's like one time a whole server together might be able to do it. But I did get some of these things. I could actually see that these are going nicely. Got 65. They spoil in 3 hours. I've been putting the poop in there. So these are really cool. I got the long grass, which we need. Spoils in a minute. It'll be fine. There'll be another crop coming up. Not fertilized. Are you for reals? And I put extra fertilizer in this one. There's carrots in there too. Carrots, okay, and get some poop in your face. Good job. Yeah, and then I've got the poop machine making up. I need to redo this. Some of these guys, like BTC, he's got a really, really cool farm in his place that he just lines them all up against the wall and like has all of his raptors together, and then they poop, or they drop eggs, and it rolls down the hill, and then they get all of their eggs there. So I think I'm gonna do that. You know what? I think I'll finish this up next episode. I have no idea how long this is with BTC's part in it. So, yeah. I like it. Decent little area. We can level it up eventually with the other stuff. I'll probably split it up. Maybe not. I don't know. It's awfully big for just a food shack. So I might move it. Now I'm thirsty again. Great. Man, I'm disconjuncted sometimes in my brain. Anyway, keep your stick on the ice. We'll catch you next time. Sure do. It's a cute little house. The heavy lifting team is here.
This is all flat land.
Yeah.
Nice.
Hey, Poopy. Hey, Poopy.
Yeah. It's because when it was born, it like appeared in like a big pile of poop.